Hi, welcome again to another episode of Dynamic Machines Podcast. In this episode, I would like to teach you how to program an offline palletizing robot using ABB Robot Studio. It's a OLP or offline programming language or software to program robots, especially for ABB robots, basically. And I will set up a layout and a voxel for robots to do the palletization, and we will see step by step what kind of component you need, and how you can insert and bring, and how we can open and start and everything from scratch. So just as a review, this is what you will see later, and it is supposed to let the packages come from one side of the conveyor, and then we have a pallet here. As you see, the robot has to, the task of the robot is basically pick up the packages and put it on the pallet in a way that it can move to the second station for wraparound or other kind of process that is needed for the package to be shipped. And I had actually designed this platform, which is itself also available on my weblog, and you can also download it if you want. And so this platform is basically using hydraulic system to be lifted, and has omni wheels to move basically on the factory floor. So yeah, as I said, this one, all these details and the structures and the CAD files is basically available on my weblog. If you are interested, you can also download it. So as you see, this starts to come to move on the conveyor, and then the robot comes and pick it up and insert it on the pallet. So it waits for the next one. So again, I need to trigger signal once, and the next package comes on the conveyor, and the robot needs to go and pick it up. So this is exactly what you are gonna see, and we will go also through the code and structure that is needed behind the scene to be able to simulate this process, and also program the robots to do these pick and placing things. Okay, so let's begin from the scratch. So our agenda is to start from the empty station. So as you see, you can, as I said, you can download the trial version of the ABB Robot Studio and try it by yourself. But this one, you try empty station, and here you need to bring all those components, equipment. So basically, from the ABB, there is a folder that you can actually open it and find your robot. So basically, first we will try to find this railing system that we need, IRBT 6004, and we define it as 3 meter and pedestrian height, we don't need it, and road angle also should be 0. So we bring it inside, and you see it is already in the program. The next one, you need a robot. For the robot part, you probably need IRB 660, which would BIR V660 is this one, and you can go for 250 kilogram as the capacity or payload. Reachability of this robot is also very huge. It's about 3.5 meter. So one of the benefit of having a 4 degree of freedom is the reachability. So I will bring it out also as well. So now I need to insert the robot on the rail. So this one is easy. You need to just drag and drop. So you drag this one as your robot and put it on the rail, and you should click it as yes. Should the robot be coordinated with the track? Yes. So now we have this robot basically inserted on the railing system. Then as I said, I would like to move these two guys together on this platform, hydraulic platform that I explained. So I will bring it as well. If you have a CAD design, a 3D model, and you want to insert it into your product, you can go to the import geometry and browse for geometry, and then you can look for the file that is actually probably inside your folder, and I would like to position this guy or set the position. We can now define, for example, this position, if I'm not wrong. So we can come here and define. So this is the vault position. I don't like it. I like to go to the UCS. This is a UCS, so basically based on the position of, and if I go local, how it would be? So it comes here again. So you'll apply, then we are now and the position that should be. But basically it is higher than it should be, but anyway, it doesn't matter. The position here to be set. Basically I would like to set the position of this guy according to this position. Yeah. And then apply. Then I say that, okay, I want this to be set position of this guy to be, and here, yeah, apply. All right, now we have the right position for the robot and its let's say platform. What other things we need to bring or insert in the program is as you see, that's the first steps are really just inserting the components inside the system. You need to I will bring a gripper. So the question is, where it is? So unfortunately, I couldn't actually find the gripper, but so in robot systems, sorry, in input libraries, you can find some available model that you can just use them as a tool. So I just insert one of them, for example, the vacuum, something like that. And so it's like that, and we need to basically rotate it. First, rotate this guy, and what we need to do, we need to mount this on the basically on this robot head. So the tool should come here. But let's see if the position hopefully is correct. So I put this on the robot. Yes. And yeah, so you see that the position of the so gripper or vacuum suction or gripper, whatever, is basically true. So now we have the position of the gripper and the robot, everything. Then I would like to bring one conveyor as well. Basically, I would like to bring a conveyor as as an infeeder. I would name it. It's conveyor 600. So I will go again to the robots, sorry, to the import system library, and go for conveyor number 600. So this one. So let's move it also in the right position. For example, here. It's a little bit higher than I expected, but it's okay. So I would put this one quite near to the robot. So what robot needs to do is to bring us from here, and this one we will name it as the car, as the infeeder. So I rename this guy and name it as infeeder. All right, this one is also inserted. Then we need to define an outfeeder. So outfeeder is the conveying system that the pallet actually comes on top of it. So for outfeeder, I need to look. All right, we have outfeeder. Let's look for an outfitter 1320. Yeah, we have something like that as outfitter 1320, and we need to basically rotate this one. So almost, and then move it forward to the other side. So something like that. Yeah, yes, that's right. Okay, so we have an infeeder and outfeeder. Then what else do we have in our system? To be very simple, we need a pallet, right? So we will bring a pallet inside. Where is our pallet? So again, in the equipment we have a Euro pallet, and this Euro pallet, should somehow has a definition. So we will say later that how we can define this, the position of the pallet to be the initial position of the pallet, where it should be.